like to introduce Martina Hirayama. She's our Swiss State Secretariat for Education, Research and Innovation. And she will introduce the field. You know, there are some kind of difficulties between Switzerland and Europe. And Mrs. Hirayama will tell us how Switzerland will continue working in this field. So Martina, if you are online, you can start speaking and the floor is yours.
Thank you very much. Good morning. Ladies and gentlemen, I feel honored by the opportunity to share a few thoughts with you. As representatives of the Swiss, European and international quantum community, you are working at the cutting edge of tomorrow's technology. Before you are starting today to explore and launch scientific cooperation or business alliances, I would like to convey my firm conviction that Switzerland is and will be a perfect place to do quantum research and innovation, as well as quantum technology business. So let us have a look at the reason why Switzerland should be this ideal place. The blunt answer is because Switzerland is among the world leaders in quantum technology and is working hard on getting even better. The boundary conditions for research and innovation in Switzerland foster highest quality. Allow me some advertising headlines. In Switzerland, brilliant researchers are working in globally competitive institutions. This output in expertise and startups feeds globally competitive high-tech industries. They employ a highly skilled working force trained by a unique and successful education system. A very competent and well-organized quantum technology research and innovation community has emerged over the years. Please let me mention a few examples where quantum technology cutting-edge research made in Switzerland is taking place. For example, there is the broadly supported National Center of Competence in Research, CUSIT, which has achieved very important milestones in the last 10 years by combining concepts from physics, chemistry, engineering, and computer science in a multidisciplinary approach. Or let's take the newly launched National Center of Competence in Research, SPIN, which focuses on the scalability, miniaturization, and error reduction of future quantum computers through research on silicon-based, small, fast, and scalable qubits. I also would like to mention the launch of the new Center for Quantum Science and Engineering, QSE Center at EPF Lausanne, or the quantum computing hub established by ECH Zurich and PSI. Of course, there are many more examples and there are new ideas taking shape in a bottom-up way within the most active and creative community. In this respect, it is close to my heart that the private sector is and remains an integral part of the quantum research and innovation ecosystem in Switzerland. It is obvious that technology transfer is essential, and there are excellent examples in the field of quantum cryptology or in the field of metrology and sensing, where Swiss quantum technology is being developed to market maturity. Switzerland is determined to maintain this successful setup and to advance its performance as one of the leading places for quantum research and innovation in the world. Please let me now say some words about the general setting in which Switzerland is embedded as a top-class research and innovation place. As a European country at the geographic heart of the continent, Switzerland has a long history of strong and successful collaboration with the European Union. This is particularly true for the research and innovation collaboration. Currently, the general relations between Switzerland and the European Union are demanding and lag behind the needs and ambitions of the European, including the Swiss research and innovation community. We all need patience in waiting for the political situation between Switzerland and the European Union to improve again. This having said, I would like to make a few important remarks. Until full association, the federal administration with my office, the SERI, will use all means available within the Swiss research and innovation system to help the affected Swiss and European research and innovation communities to keep on cooperating within Horizon Europe projects. Mid-September, we announced an initial package of transition measures to absorb the exclusions. Here we will, for instance, fund Swiss participants of Horizon Europe projects wherever legally possible. In some cases, partners from Switzerland with its current status as non-associated third country are not eligible for participation in certain calls. The Swiss quantum research and innovation community is an especially important example for this regrettable situation. In particular, Swiss partners are currently not admitted to participate in the calls of the quantum flagship in which they have so far contributed with key ideas and solutions. The teams of the federal administration are working at full speed on further measures to remedy this unfortunate situation and to further strengthen quantum research and innovation in Switzerland. This will, of course, also require the involvement of the Swiss quantum community in due course. Last but not least, and most important, the Federal Council is determined to achieve association to Horizon Europe and also to the Digital Europe program as soon as possible. Switzerland is prepared and ready to start negotiations. So I do hope to have succeeded in assuring you that Switzerland is indeed an ideal place for quantum research and innovation, as well as for doing related business. Switzerland is open to and prepared for the future and determined to contribute its share to the development of the quantum technology of the future. I wish you all the best for your conference and creative ideas for the future of quantum technology. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Mrs. Hirayama, for your introduction and the very good summary of the Swiss situation and the will to go and to collaborate with all our partners. It's a good thing for Switzerland, but also for our partners. It's a win-win situation. If I can just ask you perhaps one question that we have sometimes. How do you think Switzerland should handle in the meantime between this time now that we are not able to participate to this project and the reassociation? What are you feeling? How should we handle?
I think it's important to continue the cooperation with our European and international partners. As I mentioned, we will try to do everything to supply the necessary financial support. I think what is also very important is that our European partners explain in the European countries that the international cooperation with Switzerland is also important for them, because in Switzerland, nobody has to be convinced that European and international cooperation is important. So I would just go ahead, cooperate as much as possible. If it's not possible in Horizon Europe projects, we should be creative and look for other ways. We are always open to get in contact with us to see what's possible to support.
Thank you very much. I think it's the way to go. Be innovative, finding new ways of collaboration so that we get at the level of technology that we are now, keeping that for the next 2-3 years, and then after reassociation, continue the collaboration. Thank you very much, Mrs. Hirayama.